So we're going to briefly go through how you can numerically estimate the derivative of ln of x to find a formula. We're going to do it for the case when x is 10. So first thing we'll do is set up our definition of the derivative for f prime of 10, which is equal to the limit as h goes to 0, of ln of 10 plus h minus ln of 10 over h. Now if we want to do it for any other number, f prime of 5, we replace those 10s with 5s and we can take that limit. Now, we'll use a table to see what's going to happen as h gets closer to 0, because there's not a whole lot of nice simplification we can do. So, here's our table, and as we get closer to 0, notice that the f prime of 10 values are converging on 0.1, or 1/10. Remember what number we were looking for the derivative at? 10. Well, our derivative at 10 is 1/10. Now we would do the same thing for each of these values. If you do, you get the following results. Notice what's happening. F prime of 4 is 0.25 or 1/4. F prime of 2 is 1/2. F prime of 1 is 1. So it turns out f prime of x is 1 over x. This gives us our rule for the derivative of the ln of x. In each case, we're just taking the reciprocal. So our rule is that the derivative of ln of x is 1 over x.